makes children hyper. We've all heard this before, and maybe you've even observed it in kids. But actually, it's a misconception. There are lots of widely believed misconceptions about science that are just plain wrong. Like, you only use 10% of your brain. You really use 100% of your brain. I hope that doesn't surprise you. These are a few misconceptions about sugar that I've noticed in the past few months. At least a dozen studies have looked at how children behave on diets containing different levels of sugar, both natural sugars you find in fruit and added sugars you find in chocolate or candy and lollies. None of these studies found significant differences in behavior between kids who had sugar and kids that didn't. And in another study, parents who thought their kids had just consumed a sugary drink rated their kids' behavior as more hyperactive, even though that drink was really sugar-free. Often it's kids' surroundings that influence them to be hyper. They're excited with friends or at a birthday party. And parents often attribute this behavior to sugar. It is correct to say that sugar can cause tooth decay, but technically, it doesn't directly rot your teeth. In your mouth, you have 500 to 1,000 different types of bacteria, kind of gross, and a few species of these are thought to cause cavities. The main culprit is Streptococcus mutans. S. mutans loves to feed on the carbohydrates left on your teeth as residue, from sugars or from starch in bread or potatoes. From this, S. mutans produces high levels of lactic acid, which diffuses into the tooth and your enamel begins to dissolve. Of course, the more sugar you eat, the more residue you have left on your teeth. You may have seen this well-structured tongue map before, but there's no one area for different taste receptors on your tongue. This myth is thought to originate from one study in 1901, but it wasn't debunked until 1974. Really, your taste buds are all over your tongue. They live in your papillae, the tiny bumps that give your tongue its rough texture. In your taste buds, there's different cells that respond to sweet, sour, salty, bitter, or umami tastes. Umami being the taste of glutamate that gives meat and delicacies like Vegemite their savory flavor. Your taste cells have 50 to 150 receptors for each taste. When they're stimulated, they send messages to the brain where those specific tastes are perceived. Now, the reason I noticed these misconceptions is because I actually believed a couple of them myself. You may have seen the episodes I did last month on sugar. I did quite a lot of research for them and even had someone fact-check my scripts, but I still included a couple of things that weren't entirely correct. Deluxe Flame and some others pointed out, when you talked about sweetness receptors on the tongue, you showed an image that highlighted the tip of the tongue. Correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't that a myth proven busted? The whole tongue senses all tastes. And you're totally right, it does. R. Dizzy pointed out, studies have shown recently that it's not sugar at all that causes tooth decay. It's lactic acid produced from bacterium eating sugar that stays on the teeth for too long. Yes and yes, but keep in mind that sugar is pretty central to that loop. What I find most concerning is that the tongue map myth was busted in 1974. When I was in high school, which wasn't all that long ago, the tongue map was in our textbooks. And after that, when I was teaching, the tongue map was in our teaching materials. I never questioned it, and I still believed it years later. As Richard Feynman said, the first principle is that you must not fool yourself, and you are the easiest person to fool. So I just wanted to say a big thank you for all of your comments. I definitely appreciate them, I read all of them, and this show wouldn't be what it is without you guys and what you have to say. See you next week.